Tetzaveh. Last week I spoke about the gold of the Ark, of the Holy Ark, which represents eternality, structure, and the tree, the wood tree of the Holy Ark, which speaks of growth and development and progression. And the truth is that in the biblical period, there were two different leaders, the Kohen and the Navi, the priest and the prophet. And the Kohen was akin to the gold, and he actually wore gold vestments. He represented the eternal structure, the halakha, if you will, the temple ritual, if you will. He represented that aspect of Torah which was unchanging. The prophet, on the other hand, had to deal with every new condition and had to make certain that when you are dealing with structured rituals, you can get so lost in the structured ritual that you forget the ultimate goal. And you lose the spirit of the law in the legal casuistry of the law. The prophet had to remind the Israelites in every generation that they shouldn't lose the essence. And if, in order to keep the essence, it meant that there had to be certain changes in the law, they understood the necessity of doing it. They reminded the Jews of the essence. And that was extremely important. In the words of the Ramban, they saw to it that in the eternality of the law and the minutiae of the law, we not forget the human dynamic. A very good example, of course, is women who cannot receive a get. Sticking to the literal words of the verse, the male has to give the bill of divorcement. And we know very well from Jewish history, Talmudic history, post-Talmudic history, that generally speaking, the rabbis would do everything they can do in order to make certain, in the words of the Rambam, that our women are not like captives to their husbands. But we must find a way of freeing them. And our generation is still looking for that. Hopefully we will find it very soon. So the Kohen represented the eternality and continuity of the law. And the prophet represented the differences, the different situations, and never to forget the humanity of the law and the essence of the law. I'd like to speak to the Kohen in recounting a very interesting incident many, many years ago. Golda Meir, great Prime Minister of Israel, was invited by the Conference of Presidents, I believe it was in the 70s. I was then a very young president of the Center for Russian Jewry. It was a small organization at the time, and I was a new rabbi on the block. So I would say I wasn't really a president, as Menashe Skolnik used to say. I was a president. But I was invited to the conference with Golda Meir, and I was seated two tables away from her. I'm a people watcher, so I found her fascinating. First of all, boredom was written all over her face during all of the tiresome speeches in the beginning of the dinner. Then finally came the quarter chicken, and she seemed to perk up. What was interesting, however, was she had a balancing act to do because she was a chain smoker. So I watched how she balanced her cigarette and her knife and her fork, and she managed to do it pretty well. Then a small delegation of four people that was not on the program at all and was a surprise to everybody, including Golda Meir, came to give her a book presentation. It was a Haggadah shel Pesach that had been newly written and interpreted by Rabbi Mordechai Kaplan of the Reconstructionists. Rabbi Mordechai Kaplan was not there, although he was alive at the time. The people who were there made this presentation saying to Golda Meir that the burden of this new Haggadah was the servitude of the Jews, was the Shoah, the Holocaust, and their entry into freedom was not so much in the desert as it was in the state of Israel. And they were sure she would find it of interest. I must say that during their presentation, she also looked rather bored. Like she wanted to just get back to her chicken and she didn't want the interruption. After they finished speaking, I must say she put down her utensils, not her cigarette. She took the book. She leafed through it very briefly. And she said in true Israeli fashion, "Thank you very much, but I'm not interested," and gave it back to them. I was shocked. They looked at her in wonder as well. And whoever was the leader of the delegation said to her, "But Madam Prime Minister, you aren't an Orthodox Jew. Don't you find this of interest? You're certainly a Zionist." She said, "You're right on both counts. I'm a proud Zionist. I'm not an Orthodox Jew, and I'll never be an Orthodox Jew. But I do celebrate Pesach with a Seder for my children and grandchildren. And for me, it's critically important that my granddaughter say the same exact words that my great-grandmother said. That's Jewish historic continuity. And that's the most important thing to the Jewish people." It was an important lesson for me too. And that really was the function of the Kohen. It can't be only continuity. It must be continuity with an inner dynamic spirit. But the continuity is a critical aspect of Judaism. Shabbat Shalom.